and once more you are most welcome to crazyforveggie.com. Today I'm gonna make a pani puri. Whenever I just use this word, I almost start craving myself. I just love pani puri so much, and in India also it's almost the popular chaat amongst the all IGs. You can find it anywhere in India, either you go to north, east, south or west. There were different name of pani puri, like pani puri, pani ke batashe, Golgappa, Puchka, Gupchup and so on. But believe me, they have a different taste, different touch, but you will definitely start craving whenever you used to have them in your mouth. Pani puri is basically the street side snacks. It's widely available all over the India, even in restaurants. But you can also make that type of pani puri at home. And today I come with this recipe so you can learn how to make great Indian snacks, pani puri, at your home. So here are the ingredients for our pani puri's puri. This is semolina, suji, almost half cup, little bit more than half cup. Salt, flour, this is regular wheat flour, and warm water. So let's make a dough for our pani puri. So now it's time to make a dough. So for that, first I will add semolina, suji, salt as per the taste, and 1 spoon of flour. Mix it all properly. And then we are start to knead dough. Slowly add water to your flour mixture. You do not have to add much water, and you have to be your dough not very smooth or not very hard. So take care while adding water. Now I will going to knead my dough for another 5 minutes. So friends, it's almost 5 minutes now and I knead my dough. You can see, you don't want your dough to be more soft. Now we'll rest our dough for another 5 to 7 minutes and then after we'll start to make our puri. So it's almost 5 minutes now and my dough is already become little bit soft. Now we have to make a ball out of it. Press it really hard. And we have to make really very thin flat bread. So here what I did, I have already cleaned my surface and over here I am going to make a flat bread. Now if you wish, you can also sprinkle some flour here so it will stop to stick your surface. You can also sprinkle some on the top. So as you can see, I have made flat bread over here. Now I am going to make it in a round piece. With this you can use any size you want, but I preferably like to use this one. This is pretty big size, but actually I want all the stuffs and topping hold into my pani puri, so I want pretty big. Now we'll start to take out. So friends, this is our puri. I have made all these puris, and here I have put oil into my pot, and it's almost pretty hot now. So we are going to fry our puri now. You have to press it because we want it to be bubbly. So if it will not be bubble, then you cannot fill your stuff inside. See how fluffy it is. Now it's time to add another. Watch out very carefully while frying. Here my puri is ready. You can see how golden brown it is. You have to fry until it's become like that, golden brown. This is my pani puri. My pani puri's puri is ready, and I have decorated my dish full of with the toppings, different toppings. This is the main stuffing of pani puri. This is the black chana. I have soaked this chana overnight and boiled chana and potato together, and after I mix salt and red chili powder to it. It's very simple, it's easy to make. Here my coriander leaves, my tamarind and dates chutney, my spicy mint and coriander leaves chutney, tomato, kach tomato, onion, very fine save, and yogurt. It looks so yummy and delicious. I even can't wait to give it a try. So let's try how it is. Okay friends, our pani puri is ready, and now I'm going to give it a try. I cannot even wait. So we add some stuffing. It looks so tasty. Some onions, tomatoes. Some yogurt, and then after it's time for both chutney. This one is spicy chutney, and tamarind and dates chutney. It's time to add some sev to it, and last coriander leaves. Look at that. It looks so yummy. Now this will go into my mouth. It's so tasty. Spicy water is perfect, and tamarind and dates chutney is tastes really good. I can't wait until this all are going to finish. So friends, this was my recipe for pani puri. Hope you enjoy it. I will definitely come back with my next recipe. Till then, take care. Goodbye.